Joining us now is the chairman of PDP Laban, Senator Coco Pimentel. Senator, good afternoon to you and thank you for joining us today.
Good afternoon, Carmina, and to all of your viewers. Magandang hapon po.
Okay, pag-usapan po muna natin itong MP3 Alliance because that's the issue right here. When was it that you decided that this was the path that you were going to take as a vehicle for Senator Manny Pacquiao to take as he guns for the presidency, Senator?
Okay, number one, yung basis muna, the PDP Laban Constitution allows the party to enter into alliances or cooperation agreements. Yan. So, which we did. And then MP3 sa ngayon yan, PDP Laban, Promdi, and People's Champ Movement. Pero lalaki po yan, dadami pa po ang sasama dyan in due time. So yan po yun. And then the National Executive Committee of PDP Laban issued a resolution allowing our official candidates to choose the corner of the alliance partners.
Mm-hmm. Which one came first though, Senator Pimentel? The question about the legitimacy of your wing of the party or the alliance?
Well, meron na kaming dispute noon on time na yon, but this dispute is from their point of view. Kasi from our point of view, we are the legitimate PDP Laban. So we just act in accordance with our constitution. And it's common sense that in an election, you strengthen your party not only through recruitment into your party, but also in networking or alliance building. So ginagawa po parati yan. So that's why we did it also. We signed, I think, September, second week of September, the alliance agreement.
I was able to talk to one of the insiders in the Pacquiao camp, and the source tells me that this was basically to avoid any legal impediments that may face Senator Pacquiao's move to gun for the presidency, precisely because of the question on legitimacy. Is that the real reason?
No, that's the real reason. Maybe in the minds of some people who are not members of the party, because they also observers, but from the point of view of our party, we are a legitimate party. We move in accordance with our constitution, and by using the kona of Promdi, an alliance partner, you strengthen your support base. So meron din pong political value yun. You strengthen your support base. That is a tandaan nyo, that's a Cebu based national political party, Visayas, and then PDP Laban is already identified with Senator Manny Pacquiao, so you also identify yourself with the Visayas based Promdi. So so yun po yun, you consolidate your support base.
All right. But now Secretary General of the CUSI wing, Attorney Melvin Matibag, has these words to say. He's calling it a disloyal move, calls it the betrayal and abandonment of PDP Laban. That's pertaining to the move of Senator Pacquiao. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, una sa lahat, kasi yun ang gusto nilang propaganda. Never been for Senator Pacquiao for president. Creating all of this for PDP Laban. So that's it. Oh, yun. And they Carmina?
Yeah, I'm here.
Am I clear? Okay. They're not focusing on the Laban Constitution, which allows alliance building, the entering into cooperation agreements. Ay, latignan yan because iba nga ang gusto nilang mangyari. And then, have been expelled earlier in July.
Before we got cut, you were calling it, yan ang propaganda nila, iba ang gusto nilang mangyari.
Yes.
So let me ask you, ano ba ang gusto nilang mangyari sa pananaw po ninyo?
Well, they are against Senator Pacquiao for president. That's why they want to give him all kinds of trouble, headache, kung ano man ang pwede nilang gawin. So they are the people who are disloyal to the party and to Senator Manny Pacquiao. At bumabawi na lang yan sila, Carmina, because they have been earlier expelled by July of 2021.
Well, Senator,
did you hear me?
Yeah, now I can.
Sorry about my connection.
Yeah. What are your thoughts about the idea that they're eventually going to adopt either Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio or former Senator Bongbong Marcos as their standard bearer? Is this something that goes against or is aligned with party principles, Senator? Senator Pimentel? Okay, seems like we've lost him again. We're going to try and get him back on the line. Once again, Senator Pimentel there talking to us about the current state of the ruling party, PDP Laban. We do know that there has been an exchange of words between his faction and Secretary Cusi's faction. He just said before we lost him there that this is all part of their propaganda, and this is because they're against Senator Pacquiao running for president. Just before we lost him there, we were asking him about what he thinks about the possible move to adopt Sara Duterte Carpio, mayor of Davao City, and former Senator Bongbong Marcos as a presidential or as a standard bearer of PDP Laban. Senator, we have you back on the line. I want to get your reaction to this, the possibility of the Cusi wing adopting Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio or former Senator Bongbong Marcos as their standard bearer. Is this something that goes against or is aligned with party principles, Senator?
It goes against the party principles. It goes against political common sense and this party history. So that has been actually the from the very start. We have maintained that the Cusi group has a secret agenda. They really, if you remember, Carmina, your interview with me months ago, that has always been our analysis, that they want to endorse someone from outside of the party. So they want to disable someone from inside of the party so that they can pursue their secret agenda. Now, if it's Bongbong Marcos, then they really now betray their unfamiliarity with the history of PDP Laban, that they are really bogus party leaders and party members. They do not even know the history of PDP Laban, why it was established in the Marcos dictatorship years, to precisely to fight the Marcos dictatorship and fight for our democratic rights. So kung gawin nila yan, lalo nilang pinapakita, hindi lamang sa publiko, but pati sa COMELEC, that they have no idea what this party they are hijacking is all about. So they make it clear that they are the hijackers.
Pero Senator, you could have done the same. You could have fought for your group. But as it is, it's only them who have filed a case against your faction. Why couldn't you have done the same to fight for the legitimacy of your group and calling them the ones who are bogus, Senator?
Because we were the legitimate group, Carmina. That was the consensus among our members. We continue to act as the legitimate PDP Laban. So this is not about if you are the person who filed a case, then you argue that since I filed the case, I am the legitimate one. Hindi po yun. It's not like that. So legitimacy will have to be determined through track record, the paper trail with the COMELEC, the membership, who are the members. So, and then how, if a group claims that we have changed the leadership of a certain party, you prove that you did it correctly with 100% compliance with the rules or the party constitution of that political party. Hmm. You just cannot short circuit everything and they say, oh, you see, I have pictures of a meeting. We have a meeting, maraming attendance. E kung naghapot ka lang na attendance doon, and then we pass all of these resolutions. We are now the new leaders. We file the case. We are, hindi po pwede madaan po sa ganyan po yan na mga superficial acts. Hindi po pwedeng madaan dyan ang pag-hijack ng isang political party.
And yet, Senator, you're being called a usurper. This coming from a person who's seen as by many as one of the masterminds of the hijacking of BDP Laban.
Yeah, because that's their public posturing. So hayaan na natin sila, but then we have now this clash of positions before the COMELEC. And I think our answer is quite substantial. It's there, our answer before the COMELEC. So we are quite confident that the COMELEC will rule in our favor.
What do you say about the last minute switcheroo that happened? That it was Senator Bongo who eventually filed as a vice presidential candidate for PDP Laban.
No, it just shows that they are not really a political party. They're just a group of people who have a secret agenda that they cannot even coordinate properly among themselves. Because on September 8, they held a public formal convention proclaiming Senator Bongo as their presidential candidate. And then he publicly and in writing rejected their nomination. And then the same group nominated President Duterte as their vice presidential candidate. And he accepted through a formal speech and personally their nomination. And then here comes now the filing period. And it is the person who rejected his nomination as president who filed now for a position to which he was not nominated formally. So they have to explain to their audience. They do not have to explain to us. Kasi, I mean, wala naman kami yung pakialam na sa grupo nila. But
tell me something, though. Tell me something, though, Senator Pimentel. The president has spoken. He said that, you know, he listened to the surveys and that people really didn't want him to run as a vice presidential contender. And that's what he listened to. And therefore, the decision to step down. Do you believe that, Senator?
We keep an open mind because the period for filing is not yet over, the first period, and there's an even extended period for substitution. So take note of what you heard, but then you know keep an open mind as to all of the possible tricks that can be played upon their members, their supporters, their group, because the problem is really with their group. They're keeping their group members confused because of all of these unpredictable moves that they have been doing. But that's none of our concern. Yeah.
This is something of your concern because the same thing can be said about your group, Senator Pimentel, with choosing Congressman Lito Atienza, Representative Lito Atienza, as Senator Pacquiao's running mate. A lot of people were surprised. This was a last minute choice. I can tell you that on this show, Senator Richard Gordon told us that as early as the night before the filing of COCs, someone was talking to him to be Senator Pacquiao's running mate. Someone who is very dear to him, someone from your camp. So explain that to us. What was that process?
No, the PDP Laban delegated to Senator Manny Pacquiao the choice for his running mate. Klarong-klaro naman po yun. So whoever is his choice should be respected by the party. And then about Senator Gordon, Senator Manny Pacquiao has many supporters and maybe they approach a lot of people. So the question is, were these authorized emissaries? Were these authorized talks? So maybe people were just taking the initiative to explore the possibility of coming up with many names to be considered as his running mate. Mm-hmm. But the chemistry, I think, is there. They have been friends for a long time. Senator Manny Pacquiao was not yet a prominent person when then Manila Mayor Lito Atienza already supported him. And ito ngayong magandang kwento na narinig ko, which siguro mas maganda ikwento ni Senator Manny Pacquiao, because housing is one of his priority agenda, priority platform of government. Mm-hmm. At one time, according to Santo Manny Pacquiao, he availed of a of the housing program of the City of Manila under then City Mayor Lito Atienza. So yun po ang napakagandang kwento na mas magandang ikwento siguro ni Senator Manny Pacquiao kasi personal na dinaanan niya po yun.
Balik po tayo sa partido, Senator Coco Pimentel. How far is the party willing to go to protect this tandem?
Yes, this is going to be the tandem. This is going to be the party to the tandem, the ticket which the party will support because we proclaimed and we nominated and proclaimed Senator Manny Pacquiao as our party presidential candidate in our September 19 National Assembly. Then we delegated to him the choice for his vice presidential running mate. So nabuo na po. This is it.
I asked you that question because you know how it is. You know how things go in this country. Last minute substitution, someone sliding down, someone giving way. So is that going to be the case as well for this tandem? Or are you confident that this partnership will hold?
No, when we filed this, there's no other plan. At the time when we filed this, there was no other plan. So if there should be developments after the filing, then we did not consider this when we filed, when they filed their COCs. So yan na po yun. But you know, we should be open-minded then. If something better should come up, then we should grab it. But right now, this is the best combination.
Ano po yung something better?
I do not know. Kaya nga, you know, iba-iba kasing combination, permutations in politics. To combine Mr. X, Miss Y, ganun. So we do not know yet. But at the time when we filed the first day, that was the plan. There is no other plan.
Would you consider yourself as anti-administration, part of the true opposition, Senator?
Yes, right now, yes. Yes, the Senator Manny Pacquiao will be espousing a reform agenda. And then the priorities would be far from the priorities of the current administration.
Will one of the priorities as well be to hold this administration to account?
Yes, especially in terms of corruption. Sinabi po ni Senator Manny Pacquiao yun. Pag may ebidensya, talagang ipakukulong niya po.
All right. Now, it has been said that these are early days, Senator Pimentel. Some say the situation remains fluid. You yourself said that just a few seconds ago. But others also say that your party is in disarray. So what would you tell us now to push the idea that it is the former and not the latter when it comes to your wing of the party?
When it comes to my party, those who have remained with us, we are not in disarray. But because there's another group bringing the name of the party, then I can understand when people will think that we are in disarray, that bigger body. But the PDP Laban, the real PDP Laban, is not in disarray. We're very clear. So actually, we did even all of the resolutions that need to be passed. We passed. We took all the steps necessary under our constitution. We took them. And then it is the CUSI group which is in disarray because they took the time to publicly hold events, ask maybe the news media to cover them, and then all of what happened there they did not execute. So that is probably contributing to this notion or to this perception that some group is in disarray, but it's not our group, it is somebody else's group.
And that all of those things that you just mentioned happened with the approval of President Rodrigo Duterte. What does that tell you about him, Senator?
Well, this is water under the bridge already, so that's for them to sort out, you know. So they should coordinate with their members, with each other. If you claim to be a political party, you consult and you coordinate. That's all I can say. Which what we do. Which is what we do. We really have to spend time, you know, consulting people, calling people before making decisions. Calling for a meeting, writing down the resolution to be adopted. So this is how you run a real political party. It takes time. It takes coordination. So especially PDP Laban, which believes in participatory and consultative democracy.
Once again, I have to ask you, Senator Pimentel, because it's quite obvious that you're sparing the president from your commentaries. Why is that?
The controversy in PDP Laban is the brainchild of Secretary Cusi. So we have to hold Secretary Cusi responsible for everything which has happened to PDP Laban. But of course, we will survive this because of our unity with the longtime members of the party. So the president, let him take care of the problems of the nation. I mean, I'm sure hindi naman niya to yung mga maneuvers na ito, yung idea na ito, hindi galing sa kanya, yung pagpapatakbo sa kanya bilang vice president, hindi nang galing sa kanya, hindi na nga niya tinuloy so far. So all of this, everything can be traced back to Secretary Cusi.
Mm. Now what do you say then, finally, Mr. Senator, to those who say wala naman ho kayong pinagkaiba, whether you talk about the Cusi faction or your faction together with Senator Manny Pacquiao, that it's all the same, that it's all about retaining power, that it's all about not holding to account the president later on?
Oh, well, yung PDP Laban po, the real PDP Laban, is participating in elections so that we will win the elections and implement our program of government. It's not about holding on to power, just having power, exculpating people from responsibility. Hindi po yun. It's a program of government that we will execute, we will implement. And of course, rule of law will always be there. And if crimes have been committed, especially corrupt acts have been committed, then people should be punished. Klarong-klaro po yan, sinasabi po ni Senator Manny Pacquiao yan.
Right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Senator Coco Pimentel, glad that your internet connection there held up for quite a while.
Thank you. I'm sorry about the connection. Beyond my control. Thank you.
Thank you. Senator Coco Pimentel, then chairman of PDP Laban, joining us this afternoon.